Drumming, it connects to people. There's a thing about it where folks in community can hear one another. They can feel something in common. Hey, I'm Derek Sharp. I started building drums under the name TreeHouse Custom Drums in the year 2000. Drum building by hand is slower. It is less efficient to the point I might say it's inefficient. It's a mental exercise to focus on being precise, to measure things, to cut exactly. For example, I'll drill a hole that a piece of metal is going to fit into that's screwed on. You'll never see the hole. But I know that I didn't put the mark in the wrong place or drill it mistakenly. I knew it's a cylinder because I put it there. It's an exercise in an ethic of doing it right just because it's the right thing to do. Maybe this is my high. I make that drum, I have this anxiety, I have this good anxiety, this nervous energy to do it well. Turn the music up, go in the basement, exercise my introversion, and make a drum. You know, put on the headphones, make the world go away. I make it, it's done, that's my fix. This is my getaway. This is my emotional recharge. This is a reset for me. As a musician, it's in my soul. I have to do it. I have to hit the drum. Drumming is an emotional thing for me. Some have spiritual connections with it. Some it's about communication, because you can hear a drum over distance. In Belize, for example, all the doorways had all these little scratch marks and stuff. The guy would stand in his doorway and look at his neighbor across the path, and they would click and tap the doorways and play little drummy rhythm things back and forth. It was a community thing. When I see someone using a TreeHouse drum set on stage, when I hear someone play the thing I made, it's an honor. I think the biggest word I can put on this is fascination. I just look at this with an air of pinch me. Is this real? It's also interesting for me to hear things that different artists do with my instruments that I've never thought of. I'm that kind of personality type that wants to connect to a person. Something about this drum building is fulfilling to me in the sense that it's me a builder and you a customer. I still want to know that person because I'm curious. Is this going to be in a modern art museum in New York City on the wall that nobody will ever hit? Or is this going to get burned up in a video? Or is this going to Europe under a plane for a tour? Different people have different angles, and those stories are interesting to me. I can get at that one-on-one, but if this were a huge company, I wouldn't know those folks, and that's not interesting to me. What's a little kid in tiny town Kansas doing making an instrument that goes to Wembley Field and is played in front of 50,000 people on BBC from Topeka, Kansas, in a basement, in a building 24 feet wide? That's just amazing to me. You know, let's come together and play music together the way I know how to bring that to a group of non-musicians is the immediate success you can get in making a sound on a drum. You don't have to have a special way to hold your mouth to blow a horn. You don't have to have special knowledge. It's real basic. You take something and you smack something else with it, and you can instantly get a successful sound. And doing that in a group, sharing these ideas with folks, and you know, breaking down some barriers, that's a lot of fun. I can be a part of a family or a community or a band and not even know the good that happened when they get together to play music. And that's just fascinating how a piece of me can go out there and help people connect, even beyond my life. It's pretty neat that I can do something that will outlive me. I will make something that my customers' kids could use. Something about our industry is, as with many things in our culture, this notion of planned obsolescence is growing. I'm not in the mood. I want to make an instrument that's going to last far beyond my life. And that takes time and a little bit of experience and attention to detail to do it right so it does last and so it's quality. But that's appealing to me. I don't have the skill to carve a statue that thousands of years from now will be in some museum. I can do what I can do. I make drums. Taking the time to make an instrument to the best of my ability, to make it what, in my opinion, is right. And in so doing, I make an instrument that will last. These drums are my legacy.